In this video, if you see, I'm just going to show you program that is having function declaration, and that is a function without arguments and a return value, and with, or we can say that, or with return value. So this is the program that I'm going to write over here, in which I'm going to declare a function, and that function will not take any arguments, but that function will return a value. Whereas in the previous video, we have created a function that is without any arguments and without any return type. So here I have written the header file, and after that here I am going to create a small program in which we are going to write a program to calculate the area of a square. Okay, so here I am going to create a function first. So this function with having the return type, so I'm declaring the return type of this function, say float, and to the function name I'm saying it as square underscore area, and this function doesn't take arguments, so here I'm not putting any argument here in the parenthesis. And here in this function, what I'm doing, I'm writing and asking a person or user to enter the side of the square. So for that, I'm taking another variable of type, say float, and this is the variable name I'm putting here as the side. So here I put the message for user to enter the side of square. Let's say, and here I use backslash t escape sequence and put the semicolon at the end. Now use scanf function to read this. So I'm declaring the variable as of type float, so here the format of reading is %f for the float, and then we have to use the address operator, then we have to give the name of the variable. Now after that, what we have to do, we have to use return keyword here, and to that I'm writing site multiply by side. As we know that the area of the square is equal to side square, so that is side into side. So this way I have declared a function, and the name of the function is square underscore area, and this function will return the value as of type float when it will get executed. And here we have declared a variable side, and I'm asking a user to enter the side of the square, and after that, that will be read into the variable side, and after that we have to square the side, and the value, whatever will be the value of the square side into side, will be returned by this function in the form of float. So here I'm writing the main function. So here I write void, then main. Then here I write a message, say printf. So this is a program to calculate area of a square. And put the backslash in here, escape sequence, and then put semicolon here to terminate the sentence. Now here I am going to declare a variable, say float, and the variable name say area. Okay, and put a semicolon here, and to this area I am initializing this variable area. I am initializing it equal to say, I'm calling here the function square. Underscore area and put the semicolon here at the end. Now here I will print the value of the result or area. So here I write the area of the square is equal to, so this is in the say floor value, so we have to use the percentage f here, then put the comma, and then we have to give the reference of the variable area, and at the end put the semicolon here. Now after that, save your changes here and go to execute menu and choose compile and run. So here we got the error in function square underscore area. This is error in the line number 2. So here we are having the error. We have not put the semicolon here. So put the semicolon here to terminate the sentence. Save your changes again. Go to execute menu. Choose compile and run. Now this time our program is compiled without error and with warning. So this program is to calculate the area of the square. Now enter the side of the square. So I enter 12 here, and here we got the result. The area of the square is 144. So if we see, if we try to understand the program over here, so as soon as the program will get executed, the first of all, the main function will get executed. So in the main function, this first line will be executed. So this is program to calculate the area of the square. So here we see, now after that we have done, we here is the declaration of the variable, and after that what we have done, area is equal to square underscore area. So what I have done, to this variable area, the value will be assigned by the function that will be value returned by the function this. So here the square function is called, and square function will return us a value, and that value will be assigned to this variable, that is area, and after that we have displayed the value of area using printf function. Now let's move to this function. Here we have declared a variable of type float, that is side. Now here in this, after that I'm asking the user to enter the side of the square. So user will enter the side, and that will be assigned to the variable side, and after that the side will be multiplied by side. So this is side square is done over there, and whatever will be the value of side into side, that will be returned in the form of float, and that float value is here, if we see here at this. So this function square area will return the value of side into side, and that will be assigned to this variable, that is area, and here we got the result over here like this way. So this is, if we see over here, this is a function declaration in which we have done, this function will return a value. So this function is with the declaration of that this function will return a value in the form of float, and this function will not take any argument. So here the function is not going to take any argument. So this is how we can declare a function that will return a value but not take any arguments. So that's all for now. See you soon in the next.